Hi everybody, welcome back. This is the work that I've done on the sill so far. I slid it from here to about there, and now I'm able to have it come up really nice and tight against the A post. And I do have a little slot that I've got to fill in, and don't know if I'm just going to fill it in with welding it, or I've got some actually TIG welding wire that I use occasionally for filling these kind of slots and slits. So it fits in pretty nicely right in there. It might be too tight of a gap for the MIG, but at least I know that it's the right width. So I also put in some self-tapping screws here to get it nice and flush, get this flange nice and flush against the A-pillar. Which it is now. And unfortunately, one of the side effects is that this part of the front part of the sill now is closer to the A-pillar, which means that it's now too far in compared to where the bonnet is. This used to be a really nice line here from the bonnet, and now it's not anymore. So when I put the bonnet down, you can see that it overlaps over here. Oh, the first half, the back half is okay. And what's funny is that I went to check on the other side, which is the original sill on the passenger side. You can't see it, obviously. And it has the same overlap. So I don't know if this is a problem with this bonnet or it's just a coincidence. But I'm happy with the fit in terms of how it's going against the A-pillar now. So all those plug welds should be successful. Before, there was too much of a gap, especially over here, like I showed in my last video. So I'm going to see what happens with this. I'm not going to weld in the sill yet because I do have to fix this slot first. And I don't want to weld the sill through this slot onto the A post underneath, the A post flange underneath. So I might just tack it and then take it off and finish the welding outside. Something else that is not complete yet is I've only got self-tapping screws on the top. I don't have it on the bottom, so I can still adjust somewhat the compression over back here and over here. And adjusting the compression over there is going to be really important because the door is overlapping too much. It's out too much. So if I can squeeze the sill a little bit, maybe this lip here will come out a little bit more. You know, basically making this part of the sill up a little bit, which will bring it out. So for first, I'm going to see about tacking this up so that I can finish the repair. So that's it for now. Okay, so the welding is done. If you look at it from here, it looks awesome. A little bit closer and it's not totally awesome, but hey, it's closed and the gap is closed, and I have to do a little bit of grinding on that, but a grinder in paint makes me the welder I ain't. So this is good progress for today, and it's getting a little warm in here, so I think I'm going to lay off and let the air conditioner do its job for a bit before I come back and grind this down. So, progress! Thanks for watching. Okay, and here's the final product. It's all ground back, and it's ready for the next step, which I think is going to be getting the tension correct on everything over there. I would like to make a little shout out to these grinding discs by Ferd. Not sponsored, but these are just awesome. And the really awesome thing about it is that they're rounded, and so you can get into corners like that, either that way or this way. And they're just awesome. They take off material really quickly. They last a long time, and just the curved nature of them make it really easy to use. I actually got turned on to them by another channel, Chris Zepp Make Everything. If I could, I would buy all of those, but they're really expensive. So I'm real happy with this. It's not screwed in, so it's not flush up against the A-pillar like it would have been otherwise, but I'm real happy, and progress. Thanks for watching. Vroom, vroom.